Hi, Lynn from WisconsinGarden.net. Earlier today, you may have seen my video where I harvested about 9 spaghetti squash from our garden. And since I was having spaghetti tonight, I thought I would use my squash instead of actual pasta spaghetti. It has fewer calories than pasta, and it's very healthy, and it's extremely fresh. The easiest way I have found is to microwave the spaghetti squash. You can easily do it in the oven, but since it's in the 80s today, I do not want to turn my oven on, so I'm going to do it in the microwave. First thing always, whether you get it from your garden or you buy it in the store, wash your spaghetti squash. Make sure you get all the dirt and anybody else's fingerprints off of it who might have handled it. Then you need a sharp knife and a cutting board. Be careful. These are hard. They're a hard shell. So the first thing I like to do is take off both ends. It just fits better on my plate. See what I mean? And then carefully cut it in half. Now you can easily see where the seeds are. And I like to take the seeds out before I put it in the microwave. Now, with any squash, as with pumpkins, you can save these seeds and grow them, or you can also roast them in the oven. They're healthful and low in calories. I'm not going to do that today. You don't want to go too far into the pulp. This is the part that you're going to be using, this pulp part right here, and it's in long skinny strands, which is why they call it spaghetti squash. I believe the first time we ever had spaghetti squash was with one of my husband's students, Nora, and she taught me how to do this. Okay, so now these are clean, seedless. Since I'm going to be putting them in the microwave, they need to have vent holes in them so they don't explode. You don't want exploding spaghetti squash. So you just take your knife and you put little slices in it so the steam can get out. And as with every kind of squash, they're slippery. Now I'm going to put them on a plate upside down. The steam will be underneath, cooking it from the inside out. You could put plastic wrap over the top. I try not to use plastic in my microwave, so I'll be using wax paper instead. Now, if this were plastic wrap, I would also put vent holes in this so that the steam wouldn't build up too badly. This will cook it high for about 10 to 12 minutes. And when you go to test it, you're just going to push on it to see if it gives a little bit when you're done. You don't want to overcook it. It'll be mushy. So, in they go. Okay, let me check it. Push on the top. It gives a little bit. So I think it's pretty much done. Let me just take a fork and test it. Yes, see how easily that went in? It's better actually if it's a little less done than too done. Now I will remove it. And this has to sit for about 5 minutes yet. So before I can actually scoop it out and show you how it looks, we have to wait 5 more minutes. Okay, now you can see this is how it looks when it comes out. It's still steamy, so be careful. Now you just want to gently use a fork, and it has to be a fork, and pull it away from the sides and from the bottom. And you can see the spaghetti-like appearance of it. And it has that same texture. I need another fork. Now, if you weren't using it for spaghetti, you could also use a little bit of olive oil on it, or some butter, salt and pepper, some Parmesan cheese. And you just want to scrape it out of there and put it in your bowl. Actually, this probably is a little too done. I should have kept it out a little earlier, but that's okay. It'll still taste lovely. Kids find this fascinating, that you can get spaghetti out of a squash. So be sure to let them in on the fun. And I want to thank Nora again for showing us this years and years ago. We've been eating it ever since. It's healthy, it's fun, and it tastes delicious. What more could you ask from something from your garden? And remember, this whole thing now, the shell that's left, can go into your compost pile and help make your soil better for next time. Bit out of there. I don't want to waste any of it. Okay, now let me put it on a plate and just show you how wonderful it is. How much it really looks like spaghetti. Sprinkle a little Parmesan on there. And there you go. Dinner from the garden. Bye for now. I've got to eat.